I will introduce Gisela Madam. Gisela Madam is having more than 16 years of experience in the field of management. She is a member of audit committee. She is in charge of NSTSE. She has received Dayanand Anglo-Vedic Mentor Award. She has organized various workshops in scholastic education. She has published various research papers in the reputed journals. And she has authored more than 2 books in the field of commerce and management. We welcome Gisela ma'am. Over to you. Welcome here.
Madam, I would like to add one more important thing.
Yes, please.
Madam is the topper of 2013-15 batch from our RSCO MBA alumni.
All because of your blessing, sir. All because of you. You taught me so well. Especially, I remember decision science being taught by you.
Thank you, madam. Please continue, madam.
Such a complicated subject it was and difficult, but you really helped me in that. I'm really grateful for this.
Thank you, madam.
Over.
Please carry on, madam.
Yes.
So, good evening to all my teachers, my mentors, and dear students. So, welcome to this induction program. And myself, Gisela Makhija, and introduction has already been given by Meenakshi ma'am. So, I also have successfully completed MBA from Rashtriya Shahu College, and I'm pursuing PhD now. So, basically, learning has never stopped for me also. So, this session of ours is basically it's about unlocking your potential. So, students, I would like to tell you, first of all, take a paper and a pen, and you may want to jot down some important points or some quotes, which will help you in being motivated. Like now and then you can just refer to it, and the time when you are shrouded with the feelings of frustration. So you can just have a look at and a glance at that and just be motivated. So you can have a pen and a paper with you. So first of all, by enrolling yourself for this MBA program, you have just accomplished the first step towards fulfilling your potential. It's a journey now that you have embarked upon. No one is ahead you, no one is behind you. It is you, your decision, you have taken it to pursue and your this MBA program. It is not a contest, it's your life. We all are students, we all are teachers over here, learning. Learning goes on. It never stops. And it should never stop also. Because for our growth and development in our career, we need to learn new things which are coming up. But now that decision has been taken, have to stay committed. Never give up. Today may be hard and tomorrow may be worse, but remember, no storm will last forever. Day after tomorrow, you will definitely see the sunshine. There will be times when you will be frustrated, depressed, you will have a lot of work pressures, but tomorrow, when you see the sunshine falling on you, all the praises coming back to you, you will really feel proud of yourself. So you have to just hold on, be brave, have faith in yourself, and the sun will definitely shine upon you. Most important thing that is required now is patience. You have 2 years of course this, you need to be patient. Patience is the toughest road to stay on. Everybody agrees to it, but the surest path to victory. Now you have to complete it. You have already entered into the MBA program. You have to complete it, and successfully you have to complete it. So that requires patience. Now that you have chosen this course, this is, I am telling you, the most intelligent decision of your life. Doing MBA from such a prestigious college will definitely unleash your potential and will give you wings to explore the new dimensions of life. You will face new opportunities through interaction with your mentors and various workshops you will be attending, various interviews you will be giving. So it will definitely boost your confidence and enhance your personality. So there is a great purpose behind this decision of yours that you have enrolled yourself for MBA program. You must have thought over it. You are, because at the same time, you were passionate about doing something great in your life. You wanted to move ahead, do something concrete, constructive, substantial in your life, away from what others are doing. And simply doing graduation, BCom, MCom would not have been sufficient for your career. So now is the time to put heart and soul into it. If you truly believe in yourself, anything is possible. Don't waste your energy in worrying about the things. Use your energy to hope and believe in yourself. Always remember, life shrinks and expands in proportion to one's courage. You can note down this line. In depending on your courage, your life is going to expand. You are going to grow your career. Magic happens when you do not give up, even when you want to. As I said, there will be times of frustration, but you don't have to give up at that. You have to continue it. Continue your hard work, your efforts. You have to continue putting it. The universe will fall in love with a stubborn heart. Aapne suna hoga, jisko shiddat se hum chahte hain, wo puri kainat bhi hame usse usko hame paane ke liye puri kainat bhi jud jati hai. So it's like this only. The universe also loves the stubborn heart. So if you are stubborn in your in your goal that I have to achieve it, in your determination, so anything is possible. So if you believe, the mind will achieve it through your self-discipline and self-confidence. So success is possible only through your grit and determination, that and patience. Patience also, you need it. And lot of patience. So now you have enrolled yourself for MBA program, give it 100%, and don't feel disheartened when things don't go your way. It's okay. It's okay. It's all right. You don't have to feel disheartened about it. There will be times when you feel that you don't have that potential, that skill, which is required to do the MBA program. It's okay. You need to develop yourself. It happens at times with everybody. You have to just keep going, and within no time, you will find yourself successfully completing your course with excellent grades and making everyone singing praises of you, everyone feeling proud of you. So success is a battle with you and yourself. Nothing, nobody else is responsible for that. You have chosen, you have decided, now you have to take the pains. Okay, so use your eyes to see the possibilities, not the problems which you will encounter, the possibilities around you, what you can do with this course, what are the practical aspects of this course, how you can improve upon your skill sets. You have to focus on those things. So the habit of focusing on positive things will lead you to victory. Sometimes things may not go according to your whims, your wishes. You have to accept it. Things may be beyond your control. You just have to accept and move on. So now if I ask you, are you ready to bring about changes in your life? Because it may require quite a lot of changes. You have to change your routine. Already many of you must have changed it. Like you must have started studying for at least 1 hour a day, put in the start. Dream goal. Do you want to take actions which are really important to achieve your goals? Now, this is a big question you need to ask yourself. So now it is time to take the thing seriously, because you are embarking on a journey that requires you to make radical changes in your life. and changing your life for better is about making little improvements day by day, step by step. You have to improvise yourself. With each step, you have to improve your skills, your potential, and then only you will be able to complete this course successfully. But if you think that there is a shortcut to graduate from MBA, so I'm telling you, you will end up making your journey more long and arduous. There are no shortcuts for success. Everybody knows this. आज आप कोई शॉर्टकट से काम करेंगे, आगे चल के आपको वही काम दोबारा करना ही पड़ेगा. You have to go it. आज आप स्किप कर देते हो, आज ये मैं पढ़ूंगा नहीं, चलो जी नेक्स्ट सेमेस्टर में वही चीज आपको मिल जाएगी, फिर क्या करोगे? और वो हो सकता है इंपॉर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट हो, इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक हो, उस पे 10 मार्क्स का क्वेश्चन आ रहा हो. सो देयर इज नो शॉर्टकट. अगर अकाउंट्स आप सोचो मैं रात भर पढ़ के कर दूंगा, तो आप नहीं कर पाओगे. सो बेसिकली बिकमिंग सीरियस अबाउट मेकिंग इंप्रूवमेंट्स इज अ ग्रेट स्टार्ट. नाउ यू हैव कम टू दिस सेशन इटसेल्फ मींस दैट यू आर सीरियस एंड दिस इज अ ग्रेट स्टार्ट बिकॉज नाउ फ्रॉम नाउ ऑन यू विल स्टार्ट थिंकिंग that how I am going to go about with the things. So decision has already been taken to enter the MBA profession. You have taken the decision. You need to come into action mode now. Now the question arises, how to come into action mode. So how to act? You have to unleash your potential. Some skills you have, some talents you have. You have to unleash them. You have to open up them. You have to find out your hidden innate qualities. So the most important thing that you need to do is connect with the inner power which is within you and unlock it. So here are the few changes which I believe that it will definitely help you to unlock your potential and attain the quality of life which you aspire for. So these are the few toolkits, I can say, or the keys which help you to unlock your hidden potential. So first one is recognize the need to be your higher self. Reflect on your true vision, your version of yourself. Train your mind, growth mindset. Read books. Follow the bamboo tree. Realize your potential, master your craft, and then turn your talent into passion. So these are the 8 toolkits which you can say which will help you to unlock your potential. So let's come to first one. Recognize the need to be your higher self. What does it mean? It means to raise yourself to some standards and stay true to whatever demand is, not the demand of MBA, what it requires you to do. It requires you to put in hard work, to study, basically to study. Don't think it's a college life and you will just flip over the pages one night before the exam and just go and give the exam and you will score well. It is not like this. It's not easy. If you really want to do something substantial with your career, you need to read the books thoroughly. Then only you will gain knowledge. So whatever the demands are there, you have to pull yourself up. You have to raise your standard, unveil your hidden abilities, and discover your true strengths. See, we all are human beings. We are born with innate abilities and we are different from others also. We need to recognize what is our set of skills, what we possess, and they are the building blocks that will help us to achieve the dream goal. So always remember, everyone is born with a unique gift. And the moment you start to remember what you have, instead of worrying about what you don't have, it changes the perspective. You don't have to worry what others are having, what you need not compare, because everybody is unique. Maybe you can grasp easily by reading, the other one can grasp easily by watching a video. So there are different kind of people, different kind of skill sets. You just have to raise your standard. So admitted that you also have a greater potential than what you think you have, and you need to only exploit it. That's it. A special gift that makes you different from others. You have a special gift. You are different from others. You have to identify that. Where my uniqueness, where my potential lies. So all the top corporates, sportsperson have recognized the true power of being higher self and accordingly. So basically, you also need to raise your standards and stay true to yourself. Don't cheat. So that way you will unleash your hidden abilities and discover your true strengths. Like, for example, if I talk about an example, say some children are in the habit of making notes. They learn better when they have notes in their own handwriting. So they know their weak area, they know their strengths. They can work upon them. So in the same way, you also have to think up in that respect, how well you can utilize your strengths and work upon your weak areas. You have to strategize. Each day you have to make a plan, make a strategy of how you are going to raise your standards to achieve your potential. A small initiative you can take, like if tomorrow you have 3 classes, you can plan your day accordingly before. And when you make a to-do list that tomorrow I'm going to do these things, this is how I'm going to make the notes, these are the assignments which I'm going to complete, these are the things which my concerns are, which I'm going to ask my mentors, my teachers. So what this will allow the subconscious mind to work on the things while you are sleeping. And then when you'll wake, you know you have to focus on what all you need to focus on. So that is very important to keep you on track. And that is what many successful people do. So now let's move to the next tool, that is reflect your true vision. Now, sometimes you may get this feeling of not being good enough for your vision, or you don't have those required skills or potential necessary for you to achieve your goals. There will be time when you feel disheartened, but at that point, you ask a question. At that very moment, you can ask a question to yourself that where are you right now? And you want to see yourself after 2 years of completing MBA. And after that, let's say 10 years from now, how you want to picturize yourself, visualize yourself, in what situation you want yourself to be. So these are the questions. When you ask yourself, you will get a true vision of your future. So I believe that if you'll ask such questions, these kind of right questions, you can easily identify what you are trying to achieve and trigger the need to go for it. Like Solomon said, where there is no vision, the people perish. You can note down this. You need to have a vision in your life. Without vision, it will not take you to any goal. You will not be able to reach your goal, achieve your targets, achieve success. So now is the time to design your life. You have to design it. You have to strategize it, plan it, and start working towards fulfilling your vision. Seize the moment, make the best use of it. You have enrolled yourself. You know you have to complete the MBA. Just strive for it now. So next key, which is there, is train your mind. Nothing big happens without training your mind. There are two types of people, one with the fixed mindset and one with the growth mindset. Now ask yourself, aap apne se poochho, aapka kaisa mindset hai? Aapka fixed hai ya aapka growth hai? फिक्स्ड क्या होता है? फिक्स्ड ये होता है, आप सोचें कि आपके अंदर जो पोटेंशियल है, जो आपका इंटेलिजेंस है, जो आपकी पर्सनैलिटी है, वो आपको बाय बर्थ है, तो आप उसमें कुछ नहीं कर सकते, ये डेस्टिनी है, इसको मैं चेंज नहीं कर सकता। अगर आप ये सोचते हो तो ये आपका फिक्स्ड माइंडसेट है। और अगर आप सोचो कि नहीं, मुझे ये चेंज करना है, आई कैन चेंज इट अकॉर्डिंग टू द सर्कमस्टेंसेस, आई कैन लर्न ऑब्जर्विंग अदर पीपल। और दीपाली मैम इज सो गुड, यस, इन कम्युनिकेशन, इन टीचिंग। आई स्टिल रिमेंबर, आई यूज टू एडमायर हर। मेहता सर इज सो गुड इन हर, इन हिज कैलकुलेशंस, इन एक्सप्लेनेशंस ऑफ अकाउंट्स। मीनाक्षी मैम इज फ्रेंडली एंड टेक्स अस टू अ डिफरेंट लेवल इन द सब्जेक्ट दैट वी स्टार्ट फीलिंग सो at ease with her. So these, so we can learn from them. Yes, we can change. There is scope for change. There is scope for improvisation. So there are two types of people. So you have to figure out where you stand. Are you in the fixed mindset people or in the growth mindset people? The growth mindset, the people having growth mindset, they believe that their potential, their personality can be improved, they can improvise through learning, through experiences, through observing people. They believe that we all are born with a clean slate and every person in the planet can achieve what they want. So think about it. It's a big question mark in front of you. So if you basically really want to shape yourself, your career, your future, you need to think about what radical changes you need to make in your life from now on. So there are a lot of people who go through the routine life. They never actually make changes, and they work according to what they have been doing, working routinely, on routine basis. They are constantly and doing the same thing again and again. But what a person with a growth mindset will do, he or she will think of various methods, various ways in which they can bring about the change in life, the manner, they in the habits which they need to change to bring about such changes which are in tune with your MBA course, which will help you to successfully complete your MBA course. So maybe reading a lot, maybe talking to your mentors, more of interaction with your teachers, making notes, paying attention in the class, concentrating more. So these are the, earlier you may not be paying so much attention, but now you have to think what you want. You have to shape yourself, your thinking process. And always remember, for every action, there is greater or equal reaction. So here we are talking about the laws of cause and effect. That means if you decide to do something, there will be consequences for your actions. So if you decide to do something other than routine, which you have been already doing it, and you want to put in more efforts and work more hard, definitely you will achieve better results. So basically, you need to train your mind, study your mind. You have to study how it operates, what is its purpose. Study everything related to MBA program, your career that you have chosen. Think about the practical approaches which you can apply to your MBA program, how you can develop analytical skills, what you need to do for that. So you have to start feeding your mind with truth, with facts, with the practical knowledge, than with excuses, fears, deception. Aaj mujhe ye nahi aata, aaj mujhe wo nahi aata, mujhe ye samajh nahi aa raha. You just have to focus on your goal, on your MBA course which you are doing, and what the output you need from, what you will get from that. So that will only help you. And of course, you have to believe in yourself. we can always unlearn the things like fixed mindset. We always can learn, unlearn fixed mindset. People will think we cannot unlearn the things what we have from childhood days. But the growth mindset people will always think there is a scope for improvising our mind, our skills. So you have to unlearn the beliefs, the values which were imprinted in your mind since childhood. So we can always have new beliefs based on what we now dream and what we aspire, what we want to achieve in life. And believe me, we can do this when we have been determined and we are putting in hard work, and our subconscious mind will start working accordingly and will help us to create such outcomes that will be consistent with our goals. So that is, we shall start getting the result that will help us to take us forward towards our goals. So only thing that is required is to believe that you can, and train your mind accordingly, grow your mindset to accomplish the goals and aspirations. So next, now we come to important key, which is read books that align with your vision. Now, why and how books can be help you to achieve your dream goals? Books helps you to gain more knowledge, to broaden your perspective of what you are trying to do, what you want to achieve. They provide you inspiration, help you in expanding your understanding your vision, and are very means that will lead you to your ultimate goal. Knowledge which you get from reading biographies of successful people will definitely help you to tap upon your unlimited resources, which they also had and you also have. So basically, you will get ideas and thoughts, and you will turn them into a visible product, which in turn will help you to achieve goal. The resources they also had, resources you also have. Now you have to organize it. And how they, by reading those biographies, you will get an idea how they did it. So reading biographies of successful people will help you in modeling those people. Learn what they do. Learn how they overcame the struggles in their life. Life wasn't a bed of roses for them also. You'll get to know how they were able to achieve their goals. So in a way, they'll become your role models when you look up at them and get inspired. So it is very important to create a picture of your success. You can visualize that in future, how you are going to look like, what success or what you want is in front of you, and where are you in that picture? You have a big office, a corporate office, or you have your own business, and where you are picturizing yourself into it. So just visualize that, just taste that success. Okay. So try to imagine what you are doing in that picture. How does it look? And you need to hear the sounds of appreciation, feel the feelings, and you get inspired by your role model. So, but what I mean to say that, you have no idea that how wonderful it feels that if you visualize it, your future, and you have a picture of you, whatever your goals is, you have achieved that, and just imagine it, you will really feel great. So this is what helps you in by reading the books of successful people, the biographies of successful people. Okay, so you will not know in which direction you have to move unless and until you really have a focus, have a vision. Okay, so be very precise with what exactly your goal is. It doesn't matter if the picture right now is a little bit blurred. Okay, it will change over the period of time. That is important. So now we'll move to our next key. That is, follow the bamboo tree. So, bamboo tree. Now you must be thinking how this bamboo tree has come into MBA program. The surprise is going to open up soon. So follow the bamboo tree and it will help you unlock your hidden potential. This means that you need to build on your inner foundation, you understand, the base you have to create, and that will help you to support your dream. Now that you have enrolled yourself for MBA program and you are ready to start working towards your vision, so let's talk about the obstacles that you will find your way. So the most difficult part of walking towards your goal is to hit that start button that many of you may not have even opened the books. Okay, so it happens. It's just a beginning. So you have to start it, but you have to start. So you have to hit that start button and start taking actions towards fulfilling the dreams. Basically, you have to overcome that procrastination. Kal karenge, aaj karenge, aaj khareedne jayenge, aaj test papers hi dekh lete hain. So, and that mood swings, feeling of boredom related to particular subject or topic, frustration regarding meeting deadlines, and some days you will just be shrouded by disappointments and blocked, feel blocked and unproductive at times, basically. So maybe you'll think you have lost your way and you are not finding it a way to connect with your inner potential, or maybe you're not confident. Sometimes your confidence takes a beating. So all these are part and parcel of the struggle that you have chosen. Mind it, you have chosen. And it's only you who have to overcome this obstacle. And with what? With your grit and determination. So if you really are keen to unlock your hidden potential and exploit it to the fullest, you all need to hit the start button. That's it. Nothing more, nothing less. Just by making small moves, you have to fail quickly, you have to start, get up, and just you need to get started. So whatever, is there, you just have to leave behind and you have to just move forward. It's not whether you get knocked down maybe several times, but what matters is how many times you have got up and get started. Though you may not see the results right away, but you keep moving, keep making positive steps, and sooner or later you will start living your dream, believe me. Like bamboo tree. Now what does bamboo tree, what role does it play in motivating us? See, it grows under the soil for a long time and one cannot see the results happening for nearly say a year, but the plant is definitely not dead or dormant. It's growing. A lot has been happening under the ground, which is not visible to us. And one fine day, when all the building up its roots under the ground are all done, the work is done, suddenly you will see a shoot popping up and then a wide stalk will be there. And the tree starts growing at an insane rate, maybe a few inches or a foot a day, it will start growing. This should be similar to the field of your area, your MBA program, your future, your career. Like that, you growth you have to show, that you shall experience. You might feel for months and years that nothing is happening. You are giving your 100%, submitting your assignments on time, being very creative, being sincere, putting hard work, but nothing substantial is happening in terms of growth. You are not getting opportunities. You are not able to crack the interviews maybe. But then suddenly you'll take off as if it was an explosion. Why? Because you have been building upon the foundation. You have been growing the roots. Okay, preparing yourself, and day will come when you will also pop out from college and be a self-confident person. So don't let yourself get stuck. You must believe in yourself, give yourself a push that will give power to your vision. Remember, success breeds success. And once you start experiencing the small wins every day, you'll be hooked to it. Like everybody's having Facebook, the more likes, the more comments, how do you feel? You feel more energized, more excited. Yes, so it becomes, you become addicted to it. So in the same way, if you start winning, maybe a small type of appreciation from your teacher, from your colleague, that wah, tere ko to ye samajh mein aa gaya, tere ko ye aa gaya, acha ye question solve ho gaya. So a small win also, a small kind words of appreciation from your teacher will increase your appetite to work more hard. So then you will be making progress every day until that wonderful day arrives and you will notice that, wow, you have started living your dream finally. So now an important question that comes in everybody's mind. See, you have enrolled yourself for MBA. You know you have to increase your potential. You have to focus. You have to work hard. All this is there. But important question is, what are the skills? What are the potentials which are within us, which are in me? What steps I need to take to unleash those, to harness my inner power? The secret that lies in our sixth tool, that is, realize your potential. Now, it's within you. Nobody knows it. Maybe you are also not aware. So you have to identify your skills, your strengths, your capabilities, and focus on that. So once this realization comes, you will definitely build a better world for not only yourself, but for others. So first thing to identify is what you are really good at. What are the skills that helped you to come this far? What are the qualities that have helped you to attain whatever you have achieved so far? So what makes you stand out of the rest? So the key is to highlight such positive innate qualities in you and look for those skills which are essential for you to achieve your goals. So we are generally good at few things, but there is always one thing which we naturally comes to us. We are exceptionally good at that. And that is where the potential lies. The result tend to be exceptionally good when we focus on doing the things which we are good at. We start loving doing that thing, which it comes automatically to us. We don't have to work hard on that. But we have to identify other areas. Only one area we cannot focus on. So we have to focus on various set of skills and strengths. The road to harnessing your inner power starts from identifying those strengths and putting time in developing them. So here comes the role of the seventh key, that how to master your craft. You know your potential. You have to identify, you have already identified it. Now you have to master it. So once you have got the idea of what specific skill set you need to focus on, it's time to master it. Master your craft. This is where the dedication, hard work, sincerity comes into play. Investing your time, efforts, energy into developing your talents is very vital to achieving your fullest potential. And this is what the great athletes do and champions. They are great because they have done it. They have mastered it. It's their countless hours of hours they have spent on the training and mastering their craft that they have been to such a position. They were wholly dedicated in sharpening their iron, and result speak for themselves. Like we everybody know. So we are sorry for him also, but maybe he was weak towards his emotional quotient. But how can we forget Sushant Singh? So he was from a small town. He worked very hard to achieve what he attained. Yes or no? So it's the hard work which you put and which nobody will see, and the results will not be immediate, but it will definitely lead to fruition, and you will definitely achieve your goal with perseverance and determination. So these two things are required to master your craft. You have to be persistent, you have to be determined, and if you make decision to change, you have to stick with it. Change can be hard, especially when we are doing the things we haven't done before. It naturally involves creating new habits which we are uncomfortable. So go each day with 100% and stick to it. Make changes in your daily routine, okay, so that you can be certain about your goals, your focus, and your success. So always be eager to learn, to change into a positive mindset and challenges along the way. So last but not the least, pursue your passion. So turn your talent into passion. Now that you have taken time to identify your craft and made it perfect, the last you need to do is turn your talent into your passion. To reach your full potential, you have to love what you are doing in order to succeed it. It will spark a huge flame inside you that will push you to keep doing and better with each day and further achieve your goals and ambitions in life. It is this very motivation, that spark in your heart for the things which you do, that will lead you, that will transcend your limits and to help you to live up to your goals. To be able to do what you love and be successful for it is what we are aiming at. So everybody knows Sachin Tendulkar, our great master blaster. So do you think he had a very comfortable ride? No, he also mastered his art. He identified his potential, mastered his craft, and then turned his talent into his passion. So nothing can be achieved without hard work, determination, and dedication. Everyone takes risk in life, everyone. So never give up. Failures and rejections are all part and parcel. You cannot shy away from there. So champions keep playing, but with the right attitude, you have to move forward. Like the greatest Muhammad Ali, the American professional boxer, he said, "I hated every minute of training, but I said, don't quit. Suffer now and live the rest of the life as a champion." So you are never a loser until and unless you are trying. You have to keep on persuading yourself, keep on pushing yourself forward. So how it will be easy for you? Because you have identified your talent, which you love doing again and again. It comes naturally to you. So be passionate about your idea, your goal, and just sleep with it, walk with it, breathe with it. That every time you should have your goal in your mind. So I hope this session has given you enough clarity about your potentials, your skills, passion, goals. Definitely many of you must have started manifesting success in your mind. So as we come to end of this session, few lines I want to say. Always remember, the sky is the limit, and now is the time to spread your wings. You have to get started today, and your future is waiting for you. So thank you, students, for such a lovely being a lovely audience and patiently listening to me throughout the session. I think the time.
Hello. Thank you, Gisla madam.
To get over. Yes, Meenakshi.
Thank you so much. The students, if there is any question, please ask. Gisela ma'am will answer you definitely. Anybody would like to ask any question on unlock your potential? How to unlock? Gisela ma'am is ready to give the answers. She has various ideas. Anybody? Please ask questions, Siddhesh. I'm audible.
Hello, Meenakshi ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, please ask questions. This is the best opportunity, golden time. You can interact with your alumni. Poonam, I'm expecting from your side. Poonam, please ask question. If everything is clear to you, then it will be fine. We can go ahead. We can proceed for the next vote of thanks session. Akshada. Hello, I'm audible.
No questions, ma'am.
No questions. Everything is clear to you. Okay, fine. Amit sir, please share your views about today's session. Over to you, Amit sir. Hello. Abhijit sir, you want to say something?
Yes, anybody has a question? Everything is clear.
Okay. Fine. So I will propose a vote of thanks now. It's the time. So it has been a profound privilege to propose a vote of thanks. Thank you very much, Gisela madam, for sharing your valuable thoughts and sparing your precious time for our dear students. Thanks for suggesting the concept of bamboo tree. Definitely the students will follow it. How to unlock their inner potential. You have given the information about how to pursue your passion, turn your talent into the passion. The students must have the strong determination. They must not never give up. Whensoever they have decided to do something, they must have the passion. Definitely they will achieve their goals. I would like to thank our Honorable Founder Secretary, Dr. T.J. Sawant sir, Dr. Ravi Joshi sir, Director JSPM, Dr. P.P. Whitaker sir, our Campus Director, Dr. R.K. Jain sir, Director RSCOE, Dr. A.S. Devasthari sir, Deputy Director. Hello, am I audible, madam?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Dr. A.S. Devasthali sir, Deputy Director, Mr. Sudhir Bilare sir, and Mr. Ravi Sawant sir, Executive Members, JSPM. Dr. Amay Chaudhary sir, our HOD, MBA department, who always motivate us to organize guest sessions and various programs. I would like to thank our MBA faculty members for their continuous guidance and support. I would like to thank our dear student managers. Last but not the least, thanks, dear Deepak Purbeti and Siddhesh Tiwari for their continuous support with us. God bless you all, my dear students. Now I would like to ask if any faculty members would like to interact. Gisela ma'am, please say a few words. Abhijit sir of the
yes, madam.
Yes, Amay sir, please.
हेलो
आई थिंक वॉइस इज
नॉट सर
हेलो हाँ
यस वॉइस इज ऑडिबल यस सर Go ahead.
Yes. So, on behalf of all the students, I thank Gizla madam. She has given precise examples and she has given very good insight on the requirement or expectations from the budding managers. And being MBA students, how they should mold themselves, how they should develop themselves, that is very important. And really, very good input for all our students. Even we faculty members are also working on this, and we also accept this type of inputs for our own development also. Gizla madam, once again, thank you very much, and for your wonderful session, as well as thank you very much for sharing your views on this occasion. Thank you very much, madam.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Abhijit, sir, you want to say?
Hello.
Yes, please.
Yes, your voice is audible, sir. Go ahead.
Audible?
Yes.
Hello.
This is a golden
Hello,
opportunity.
Sir. Hello. Good evening, Abhijit, sir.
How are you?
I'm fine. I'm good. How are you?
I joined late because of some technical issue, but the lecture was fantastic.
Thank you, sir. All learned from you.
Indeed, a pleasure listening to you. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much for making it today, and it was a nice presentation you gave. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, madam. Gave a good presentation and inspirational and motivational session. It was really, it was fantastic and excellent. And thank you for this particular session, and she gave a lot of things to become a transactional and transformational leader. So it was a mind-blowing session, and it was beyond the expectation you crossed, and very, very nice. And I hope such a type of session for our students, you time to time, if you have a time allow, you take the lectures so that our students will take some guidelines,
sir. Sure.
In the future too. Thank you, madam, once again.
Sure, sir.
Any other faculty members?
Heartwarming words. Really felt so nice. Thank you, Meenakshi ma'am.
Meenakshi ma'am, just you wish to speak something?
Yes, hello? Please say.
Hello, Makija ma'am. It is really nice to see you here and alumni session, and it was a really fantastic session. I may not have directly interacted with you or directly taught you any subjects, but I always heard about all the alumni, and you are one of the person jiska hamesha every time sir keeps on talking. And about your all the academic performance and all the sincere efforts, all the sincerity, attendance, he keeps on talking about this, and it was really fantastic session. Wish you all the very best, and thank you very much.
We are proud of you, Gizla ma'am.
Man, really fantastic.
Fantastic session.
Thank you, I'm so obliged.
Throughout 1 hour, I listened.
Thank you very much.
Deepali ma'am, please say something. Are you there?
Hello.
Yes.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, madam.
Okay, Gizla, it's always special to connect with an alumni like you, and definitely we do remember you. We have never forgotten you, and you will be always there with our memories, in the sense that how the way you used to come and share ki ma'am ye pata nahi main pass ho jaungi ki nahi, and you would put utmost hard work. We could see your hard work, but then at the last moment there would be some butterflies in your stomach saying kuch to tension mein ho. So I still remember those days of yours, and I'm very happy to see you your growth basically, and very happy to connect with you. Stay in touch.
Thank you so much. Yeah, sure ma'am. You keep on calling me, I'll be in touch.
Definitely. Even we expect calls from you now.
Yeah.
Great to see you.
Thank you so much, Dipali ma'am. So nice feeling.
You should actually visit college someday to meet all of us.
Yeah, definitely. Meenakshi ma'am, your voice is not audible. You're not audible.
Mehta sir, bye-bye kar dete hain madam ko. Chaliye.
Haan ma'am.
Chaliye, thank you very much.
Okay. Bye.
All the dear student bye. Managers.
Thanks a lot for taking that session. Thank you.
I will share the link of today's recording.